How is he?
He needs rest, but I think he's out of danger.
Does he have a name?
Hildas Feeney. He's been a good friend for a long time.
I've never seen a boy like him. You said he was the last in the realm?
The last in this realm. He's from somewhere else entirely. Back home, he could take any form he liked, but since he came here, he's been stuck.
Stuck as a boar?
Stuck in his mind. His own true nature grows faint in his memory, like a dream, while the illusion feels more real every passing day.
I'm not sure I understand.
To live, simply to live in your physical form, day after day, it's hard to resist believing you are your form. In youth, he might have had the strength to rebel, but Hildas Feeney is very, very old. Without me to remind him of home, of himself, I fear the boar is all that will remain.
Well, I hope he finds his way home.
Thank you, child. I do too.
See you later.
Be safe.
I see a boat.
Be ready.
Mom used to tell me. Didn't think they were actually real.
Nightmares?
Yeah. They give people nightmares. But they are nightmares. I don't remember which. I wish I could ask her.
Touch the water.
Why?
Do you know what is under the surface?
No. It's pitch black.
Then do not touch the water.
can't burn it, can't cut it.
Get to the mountain quick. I just can't believe I'm here, in all this. There was a time I thought I'd never leave our woods, or even my own beds.
You are not to blame for your sickness.
Oh, I know. I guess I'm just saying. This is great.
There's the mountain. Look how close we are.
We flow into seawater.
How do you know?
Do you not smell it?
If that smells the sea, the sea stinks. Look at that. It's Thor.
Thor, god of thunder.
That's right. I never thought you'd listen when Mother spoke of the gods.
I seldom did. Did she speak of one who could feel no pain?
Oh.
That sounds like Baldur.
Baldur.
An Aesir god, son of Odin and Frigg.
And Odin is king.
That's right. Why do you ask?
I see something, just sitting there in the middle of the lake. I see runes there, in this chest. I can't quite make it out. It reads, sacrifice your arms to the center of the water. Awaken again the cradle of the world. What? Throw our weapons into the water? Guess that won't be a problem for you. Are you gonna do it?
Did not return.
Shipwreck way over there. See that? And there's a statue of Thor. Except I can see a lot more of him now.
The water dropped and the serpent rose.
Oh, that must be why the beach wasn't there before. See? And there's the mountain. Look it. That building leads from the foot of the mountain to that golden temple.
It was all just under the surface.
except for the statue. Good thing, huh? There's even a dock. There, next to the flag. We're going to the dock first, right? We'll be the first people to walk on it, and who knows how long.
You know that serpent?
He's one of the giants. He's so big, he's wrapped around the whole world and bites his own tail.
An exaggeration.
I don't know. Looked pretty big to me. Oh, good. I was hoping we might explore a little.
When we wish to continue our journey, we know to return here.
What happened here?
Shipwreck.
Well, yeah. I wonder why it crashed. Hey, look! A torch!
A torch is built with wood. That is a brazier.
A brazier. Looks like there's something written on it. Want me to read it? Did I do okay?
Not bad.
Well fought, you two.
What is that?
A spirit.
It's talking to us.
And it hears you as well. Be shy now.
You're dead?
You're very perceptive and reckless. Take caution when lighting these braziers. Sather and Hellwalkers will swarm to the flames like moths. I assume we have you to thank for freeing us from a watery grave.
Us?
Other spirits. The Lake of Nine is full of them. Most are able to move on from this realm. But we, lucky few, are stuck here in Midgard until our affairs are in order. Perhaps you can help them as well.
We have no desire to help you, Spirit.
Ah, but you already have. I only wished to see the sky again. Farewell.
He disappeared.
Come, let us not be distracted.
So, I guess we should keep an eye out for other spirits.
What did I say about distractions?
But it sounds like they needed help.
They are spirits, boy. Dead things. They have no needs, only wants.
It feels wrong to ignore them.
You will get over these feelings.
Mom would have wanted to help them.
What was that, boy?
Nothing.
I thought as much.
Hey, it's another brazier.
I suppose you wish to light it.
Can I? Kavika!
I don't believe it. Are you both alive?
Hello.
I can't remember the last time I saw something walk these islands that wasn't dead or corrupted.
What do you mean?
The desolation, child. Plagues this land, growing more severe with each passing winter.
Do you know its cause?
Not for certain, but I suspect the appearance of the World Serpent, along with the great flood that followed. Many were drowned, myself among them. The dead began to walk not long after.
Do you need anything from us?
Boy,
I only wish to speak to someone again. A wish you have just granted. Thank you.
Listo! have what we need to deal with that.
Roy, what did I tell you about offering help?
Don't.
Correct.
But can't we
just... This is not a debate. You must learn focus. Our journey need be your only concern.
But what if they can help us? That one seemed to know a little about the lake.
And how does that help us with our goal?
We won't know unless we ask. Serpent's even over here. I told you he's big. We can beach over here.
Enemies are strong.
Well?
Well, what?
The brazier?
If you must. Roy, over here.
Yes, sir. Kavekia.
Focus up, boy.
The axe isn't working?
Well done, boys. Never thought I'd...
What do you want?
To thank you. These dead Reavers drowned me many winters ago, and I've been itching to see them get theirs.
So you died after all the flooding?
Indeed. I came to the Lake of Nine to pillage Tyr's temple, but I underestimated the severity of the desolation.
Have you seen other men? Living? A bearded one, with tattoos.
Only the one standing in front of me. Thank you both for avenging my death. Useless.
Well, we can't expect them all to know something useful. We should look for more like this. Hey, that could be valuable.